3102 Gibbons. Pretty quiet. I don't hear any loud highways nearby. And it's low traffic. Surrounding houses look nice. Neighbor's house looks nice. Both sides. It's quiet. Seems like a nice area. Driveway goes all the way back. About two or three cars. And these stairs are almost new looking, good condition. Railing needs to be fixed. The walkways are pretty good, there's some cracks. Might have to look at the picture for a better view of the roof, but it's slate. And it looks okay in some spots, but the slate looks really old. Some damaged. I can get a better view when I'm up on the deck on the back. Siding looks like good condition. The fence needs some repairs, but it's pretty good all the way around. Indoor and outdoor unit are still here. Not sure if it works. Medium-sized backyard, nice little patio area, deck on top. We back up to other people's yards. It's quiet. Alright, we have a shed here. Some repairs needed. The gutter's falling down right there in the corner. Some of the wood looks rotted underneath. And then down the other end, it's just overgrown quite a bit. Walkways back here are in good shape. The house looks nice, shape and size. Compared to the other houses, it doesn't stand out. Looks like a nice looking old home. Foundation on the outside looks good. On the inside, I noticed some soft concrete decaying type stuff going on. The driveway's in good shape for the most part. Both the neighbors are well kept on both sides. Don't have cluttered yards. This front porch is in good shape. It's a nice big multi-level front porch. There's just small repairs needed up here. But for the most part, it's sturdy and level. Maybe some paint through the front door. There's a foyer area, kind of stairs up. Coat jackets. This wood, maybe. Save and paint, but the rest of the house is stucco. Start here to the walk in. To the left is a living area, open to a dining area. So one large room, textured ceiling, and plaster or stucco walls, but they're all in pretty good shape. An older style vinyl window. I think that personally they need to be replaced. I opened a couple of them. They don't seem to stay up when you open them. And straight back is the kitchen. She needs all new cabinets, tile, and appliances. It's all paneling in here. Maybe manage to save these old cabinets. Plumbing looks good throughout the house. Looks like all copper and PVC. And a back door. And then off to the side is a master bedroom. Small closet though, but has a connected bath. This is all plaster, stucco as well. But again, it's pretty smooth and in pretty good condition. This is the small closet area. Pretty small. And then the full bath needs all new tile and fixtures. Two ways you can get downstairs through this living area, and then that bedroom has two entrances, one here and one down there. Do the basement first. She had to duck a little bit here, but once you get down, it's nice tall ceilings. A pretty large opened area. Over here, the structure looks good. Then I saw some spots similar to Glendale where the concrete seems to be decaying in between the rocks. It's a half bath over here, plumbed in. Seems to be mostly copper plumbing down here. Or PVC, I'm sorry. One beam runs down the middle. Goodman unit and newer looking ductwork. Hot water heater. Maybe reusable, no rust. And it's PVC plumbing coming off. The ductwork sits right at the same height as the beam. And then electric panel. It's an older panel, 100 amp. The wiring looks okay though. And there's about a 2-foot concrete wall. that separates you from this back room, which I think we should finish this whole area as a living and maybe bedroom even. And then back here, try and squeeze washer, dryer, and the utilities. I guess it would be a pain to move. There's a sump pump back here. It's an older style. I don't know if it needs waterproofing or not. Cracks in the cinder block here. And then some softer stuff. I think that's it down here. The joists look good. I don't see any termite damage. No mold or rotting. The floors are all pretty level. In the basement as well, it was pretty level. The kitchen was a little bit swayed. Oh, the stairs. The second floor is 4 bedrooms, 3 and a small one. There's a good sized bedroom. It's all paneling in here. Here you can see the front porch roof better than from the outside. It looks in great shape, almost new looking. And then there's a second bedroom that's about the same exact size. Maybe this one's a little smaller. They all have closets built in. And this one I see some water damage in the ceiling. Then there's the smallest bedroom, which is very small for a bedroom. Might be an office or something. And it leads out to the back porch. I think these old style doors would kind of be cool to restore them. Clean them up a little bit. Half opening doors. And need to maybe redo this deck top. It's like roofing material now. I'll give you a view of the backyard. And then we can get a closer look at the slate from here. Almost looks like it's so old that it's decaying a little bit or wearing down. This is the shared bathroom on this level. This tile work in here looks pretty good. Plumbing you can see through in this room. It's like copper. And the floors pretty level up here, a little bit off there. A little bit off there. And then there's a 4th bedroom, which is the biggest, and it has a large walk-in closet attached. All paneling on this whole level, some missing here. The walk-in closet, which also has some damage. Then stairs up to the attic. It's all paneling up here. Notice that coming up. Walk up for a third story. It actually feels very open and nice tall ceilings. We walk down here, it's like 6'8", feels nice and tall. Well, for me, I think you could add a, there's a half bath up here right now. I think you could add it, make it a full, and have a stand-up size shower up here without a problem. Notice how where the bathroom is now, though, it slants down too far to put a shower over there.